You thought the IRS targeting scandal, controversy, whatever you want to call it, was forgotten? Think again. In an exclusive first on CNN report, House Oversight Committee Chairman Darrell Issa is now demanding a copy of all communications between the IRS and the Federal Election Commission over the past 5 years. CNN Chief Congressional Correspondent Dana Bash is breaking this news and joins us with the details. Dana, this news was prompted by something you reported earlier this week.
That's right, Jake. We reported earlier this week about an email that came from an investigator at the Federal Election Commission to Lois Lerner of the IRS, asking about a conservative group called the American Future Fund. Now, the vice chairman of the FEC, Don McGahn, was the one who told me about this email and said it raises questions about whether there was inappropriate contact between the two agencies about this group. Now, the House Oversight Chairman Darrell Issa, at this point, is expanding his investigation. He announced it today. At least he did so in a letter to the head of the FEC. CNN obtained the letter. And what he's asking the FEC to do is turn over records from more than 5 years of communications with the IRS. The letter cited CNN reporting that raises, quote, the prospect of inappropriate coordination between the IRS and the FEC about tax-exempt entities. Now, among the things that ISA is demanding is all communication between the IRS and FEC dating back to 2008. Now, I should underscore, Jake, that Don McGahn, the Republican FEC commissioner who I talked to, he underscored that he is not sure that anything nefarious was going on here, anything sinister, but because this is could be inappropriate, it should be investigated. Now it is.
Okay, and just to underscore, just so we understand, because a lot of acronyms and people outside of Washington, D.C. So the original controversy is whether or not the IRS was unfairly targeting conservative groups, not allowing them to have tax-exempt status because they were conservative. That was the allegation. Mm-hmm. And this is about whether or not the IRS, the same people that were allegedly unfairly targeting, were also reaching out to the Federal Election Commission?
Or vice versa, or whether the people at the Federal Election Commission were reaching out to the IRS. The bottom line here is that if there's information in the public domain, there's nothing illegal. They could talk to each other about this conservative group or any group out there. If it is private, it could potentially be illegal. So that is basically what they're looking at. Now, again, we don't know if there's anything that was sinister that went on here. Democrats are emphasizing that, saying Republicans are just throwing mud against the wall to see what sticks. But the fact is that these emails, one that was described to me, another that the House Ways and Means Committee put out, do show that there was communication that, you know, is questionable. And that's why now the Republicans are expanding their IRS probe to yet another important agency. The Federal Election Commission, of course, basically regulates political speech. So,
and Democrats saying nothing to see, this is a witch hunt,
exactly.
Fishing expedition. Darrell Issa hasn't found anything in his first attempt. Now he's expanding because he can't find anything, and he's just going to keep going.
That's exactly what they're saying.
Okay,
we'll
Dana Bash, keep us posted. Thank you so much. Great reporting.